Hello everyone, my name is Nathan, and today it's time for another episode of Let's Make a Game in GameMaker Studio 2. In today's episode, I want to focus on a little bit of dynamic tree growth. You might have already seen it, some of the trees actually grew, and they went to their next stage of growth. And of course, we also want to apply getting more materials if they are in a higher growth stage. You can see this one just went back to a sapling. I just left it at that in order to get this cycle going on. And of course, the trees are growing much faster than I want them to grow in the end. But that's just how it is, and that's what we are going to try out. So let's go ahead and do the first steps for this. I made myself two new scripts, the world regrowth creation and the world regrowth check. Both of these scripts are on the object world tree that we have made. We have one on the create event, we have the script world regrowth create right here. And we have one on the alarm zero event, which is the world regrowth check. So that is the setup that I have prepared for today's episode. We're gonna write in the code together, but just so you know which scripts I created and where they are located. Now, one more thing that I did is I actually added a better sprite for the tree. So if we have a look at the trees, we can see we now have four growth stages. One is the sapling, then we have three additional stages. Now, one thing we had to make sure is that the collision mask still matches somewhat what we want. So I cannot change the collision mask for the different sprite. For that, I would have to make a completely different sprite and not just an additional image. I also made the images a little bit higher, so now the trees can grow two tiles high, so they are significantly, well, not significantly, but a little bit higher than the player. Which also means I had to change the point of origin to 32. So in case you are programming this along with this tutorial series, those are the things that you will have to prepare in order to continue right now. First things first, let's open up the global variables. There's a couple of things, a couple of variables that I want to initiate right here. There's two variables that I want to add. The first one is the global.growthCheck. Jeez, I cannot type growth. And we want this to be equal to the room speed. So what this basically means, the growth check is gonna be executed every 1 second, because the room speed, of course, is the frames per second that we have. So let's say it's 60 at the moment. That means every 60 frames we want to do a growth check. However, thinking about this, I might actually switch it into one of the other scripts, but let's go ahead and do the next variable first, which is the growth chance of the trees. And I want to set this to approximately 50. And these numbers are gonna make a sense in just 1 second. Let's actually go ahead and open up the world regrowth creation script. Now, since this is on the create event, I don't really see a reason why we couldn't take these variables and just put them down there. We don't really need them in the global script. I mean, I want to keep the global script reserved for stuff that I really need on a global scale. And since I place these scripts on top of the trees themselves, we can just do it here. And we also can take away the global if we wish to do so. I'm just gonna title these regrowth variables, and then we are gonna do the trees first. Now, I want to place this script on every object that has the potential to grow or change over time. So we will have to address the specific object the script is on, since the script could be on trees, it could be on wheat, and we want trees and wheat maybe to have a different growth chance, so that's why we set all of these up right there. But as for the trees, let's do this one first. So we have to check which object the script is on. The variable for that is object index. So if the object index is world tree, then we want to go ahead and do something with the images. First of all, we want to set the image speed to 0 because we don't want it to flicker through all the trees, right? What we also want to do is set the image index to something random. Once again, opening up the tree sprite, we have images 0, 1, 2, and 3. So we're gonna need a random number when we first start with the tree. I want them to be in a different growth stage depending on chance. So we're just gonna say floor, and we want to do a random 4. This will choose a number between 0 and 3 because floor is rounding down, so 4 wouldn't be possible with this. Next up, we want to set the alarm, and this is a function I haven't used a lot, even in my previous series about GameMaker. What this basically does is we want to set an alarm that ticks off every now and then, and of course it's gonna be the room speed. So every 1 second we want the alarm to go off, so that's what we are gonna do. So we're just gonna set the alarm equal to our growth check variable. And that is basically it for that. So now we will have to do a regrowth check. And I think I want to divide this up. This is going to be a fairly large script since I want to place this on a lot of things that will spawn in the world. Now, theoretically, this should be all that we need for the trees themselves. So we could add more and more items using this formula. And we can go into quite a lot of detail here. But I think that's going to be it for this script. Let's go ahead and open up the world regrowth check. Now, if you don't remember, this is on the alarm zero event of our tree. And it's going to be on the alarm zero event of a lot of objects where we want some type of growth happening. Now, the world regrowth check script. What do we want to do for that? First things first, we want to redo the alarm. So theoretically, if we do this on the create event right here, we will only tick off the alarm once and then it's gonna do this script, but it's not gonna do it over and over again. So what we're gonna do, first of all, we're gonna set the alarm zero once again to our growth check variable. So we're basically doing the same thing as here, but that just means we're doing it over and over again now. Every time we are doing this, I want the trees to have a certain chance to actually be able to grow. And this is where the growth rate is coming in right here. I can simply adapt this if I want them to grow faster or slower. So let's go ahead and define a variable. I'm just gonna call this chance. So what is the chance of something growing? We want to have another mathematical function. I'm gonna do a random and then we're gonna take the growth chance of the trees that we made, which is 50. And holy cow, I don't wanna write this word anymore. So what this is gonna do, it is going to choose a number between 0 and 50 because 50 is what we have set up there. So once we have chosen this number, we can just say, for instance, if the chance equals 0, then we want the tree to grow. So every 1 second, we are gonna change this number, the chance number, and every time it is 0, the tree is gonna grow. That means in order to grow the tree, we simply want to do an image index plus equals 1, and it's gonna go to the next image that we set in the sprite. Great, so I think that is already all we need. Did I do something wrong here? Unnecessary expression, of course. There's an equal sign missing. There we go. So with that out of the way, we have the same situation we had when I first introduced today's video. However, the trees are not dropping any more logs. So what could we do about this? First of all, let me find where we actually set this up. We have the movement here. We have the pickup functionality. That seems reasonable. So right here at the harvest functionality, what we're doing is we're finding the nearest tree. And all we want to do is increase the amount of wood we're getting depending on the image index. Now with this function, we are already on the nearest tree. So everything I write in this with statement is going to be as if it is on the tree itself. That means what we want to do is change the amount of wood we're getting. And I'm gonna try to do this with a plus image index. And we could even do plus image index times 2, for instance, just to get a better, more visual effect of this. So what that is gonna do is gonna take the amount of wood. And if we are on image 0, then it should be just the normal amount of wood. And if we are on a higher image index, let's say for instance image 3, then we should be getting 6 additional logs, because 3 times 2. Now of course I only want this to be plus image index in the end. I don't want too many logs to drop. So first things first, let's wait for one of the trees to grow. I just want to see this. Yeah, there we go. This one just went to the next. Now let's go ahead and pick this tree. We are getting 3 logs. Now let's do, I just missed this bad boy. Let's wait for another tree to grow to its full stage. Or actually we can do this one. Yeah, we can clearly see this is working. We are getting significantly more logs because even though the amount of wood is a random number between 1 and 4, I believe, we are getting a lot more doing this. But I'm gonna remove the times 2. I just want a plus image index. So you can potentially get 3 additional logs. Now the rocks naturally are not going to grow, but we might want to add some stuff to actually make them respawn in the world, even if it is a mysterious thing to happen. I mean, we don't want to run out of stone, etc., right? But yeah, I guess that has been it for these scripts. I'm just gonna close it off. And what we now can do is we can go back into the regrowth creation thingy-majingy, and I want to add a little less chance for the trees to grow. So maybe let's do 200. So theoretically, only every 200 seconds, the trees should grow, on average at least. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. I like that. I mean, the trees could theoretically grow a little bit too quickly if we get really lucky with getting the number 0. But yeah, I'm happy with that result. I would say I'm gonna wrap this video up. I'm gonna record another one, but it is thematically not really wise to also put it in this video. Yeah, but I certainly hope you enjoyed today's video. If you have any suggestions on what we could do next, I'm totally eager to listen. But don't forget, we don't want to go into too much detail just yet. We want to have a really good framework for the entire game before we go into the detailed stuff. With that out of the way, thank you so much for watching, have a great time, and hopefully I'm going to catch you in the next video. Bye bye.